The Philippines will begin the nationwide vaccination of minors ages 12 to 17 today. An earlier pilot program included only children with comorbidities staying in select hospitals. Now, more vaccination sites will be opened across the country to accommodate the general pediatric population. Each site targets to inoculate up to 1,500 children daily. Meanwhile, some local governments in Metro Manila, such as Malabon, Marikina, and Navotas, already went ahead with vaccinating minors on Tuesday.
Nakita po namin sa aming listahan na paubos na po yung with comorbidity. Meron na kaming na italang at nabakunahan na 921 minors.
The Philippines' COVID-19 vaccine drive gets another shot in the arm. The country has received 2.7 million more doses of Sputnik V, the single largest shipment of the Russian-made jab to the Philippines. The government-procured shots arrived Tuesday afternoon. The widening vaccination coverage in the country has been cited by independent research group OCTA as among the reasons for the decline in new cases in the past few weeks. So far, over 27.4 million Filipinos have been fully vaccinated against COVID-19. The government aims to complete the inoculation of up to 77 million people to achieve herd immunity.
Nearly 150,000 COVID vaccine doses were destroyed on Sunday in a fire in the southern Philippines. The vaccines were stored in the health office of Zamboanga del Sur province. Officials of the Interior and Health Departments are investigating why the vaccines had not been immediately distributed to inoculation centers.
It is beyond beyond us, no? Kasi force of nature yan, yung fire. But we will have to look bakit napakarami nung bakuna nila, bakit hindi na-move. So we will look into that and then see who are accountable.
Malacanang urges state medical insurer PhilHealth to settle the unpaid claims of hospitals. The call comes after the Private Hospitals Association of the Philippines renewed its threat to cut ties with PhilHealth if no progress is made. The group has said most COVID-19 claims from last year, worth up to 20 billion pesos, remain unsettled.
Mananawagan tayo ulit kay President Giran. Paulit-ulit na po sinasabi ni Presidente sa kanya, alam ko po ito, paulit-ulit na sila nag-uusap. Hayaan mo ng bayaran yan. Dahil sa panahon ng pandemya, talagang magkakagulo at magkakaroon ng kakulangan kung ang mga pribadong hospital ay hindi kasama sa universal health care.
Senator Sonny Angara also expresses concern over PhilHealth's debt to hospitals. He believes it's high time for the anti-red tape authority to intervene.
Maybe it's time to do some tweaking already there in the system because it's been a problem ever since. That's why PhilHealth has always changed its periodically changed its fraud management and its system for evaluating claims. Maybe it's time to get people in from the private sector and maybe time for the ARTA to step in, the anti-red tape authority, because we have this government agency whose job is to make sure claims are processed or government processes the claims of the public quickly.
For Senator Joel Villanueva, PhilHealth should aim for a zero backlog goal. He maintains a delay in reimbursement of claims would make it harder for hospitals to retain critical manpower.
The Philippines logged 2,303 new COVID infections on Tuesday, the lowest single-day tally in 8 months. 128 patients also died, while more than 4,000 recovered from the disease, bringing down the number of active cases to over 40,000, the lowest since March 9th. But the health department notes while the number of new cases continue to drop, it's now happening at a slower rate.
Pag bumabagal nga, tama ka, yun ay higit nating pinabantayan kasi yung pagbagal na yun, posibleng makita natin from a negative, nagpa-positive tayo. Isa sa posibleng dahilan ay habang bumababa ang kaso, minsan meron tayong mga areas na medyo nag-ease up but their active case pa.
Davao City drops the mandatory use of face shields. In an executive order released Tuesday, the local government said the wearing of face shields will now be voluntary and is only recommended in crowded areas as well as confined spaces. Davao City also lifting the mandatory use of barriers on motorcycles and in public utility vehicles. These developments come amid a decline in COVID-19 cases. The national government, meanwhile, is still discussing the possibility of lifting the face shield mandate in all parts of the country.
Dahil umababa ang numero, marami ng kumbaga nagsasabi sa IATF na baka dapat itigil na rin ang pagsusuot ng face shields. Pero wala pa pong desisyon na susuot pa rin po tayo ng face shields. Lalong-lalo na dun sa 3 C's, no? When in the outdoors.